Good day, everybody. Connor McIver. A lot of people ask us how we get that market data and how we compile it so everybody knows what's going on here in the Santa Clarita Valley market. I'll tell you, I do have kind of a cool system. So let me give this to you and I'll show you what we do when it comes to publicizing the market data so you can actually see it and so people can take, you know, small bite-sized chunks of it. So let's go ahead and pull this out here. I just need to find the right access point. So we're going to go ahead and go to SCV blog. And one of the most recent articles I've written, actually the most recent, so hence this video, is about five recent trends for Santa Clarita real estate. So I look at five things when I'm putting the market together. Of course, there's other dynamics that get involved, but these are like the main things that are looked at with regard to Santa Clarita real estate, wanting to know and answering those questions that people have pertaining to the local market. So the first thing is going to talk about new construction and new homes. If the new builders are pulling out of the market and they're leaving town, it's probably a good indicator that something bad is about to happen. This is something that we did see last real estate cycle. They weren't all abrupt like that, all of a sudden one day there, one day gone. But towards the end, as we got closer to 2007, they definitely were slowing down. So that's something to watch. Right now, currently in Santa Clarita Valley, and this is the intel here, so let me pull this. You'll see here in Santa Clarita Valley, there's just a ton of new housing construction. NewSantaClaritaHomes.com, NewSantaClaritaHomes.com. That's my system, but you'll see it here. I mean, there's just so much building, and they're continuing to build more. They do have a lot of new inventory that's going to be coming as well. Next thing we want to look at is the resale inventory. And when we're watching this dynamic, as you can see here, the graphic has been very cyclic, like all of real estate, up and down, of course. Now we're swinging into an upward trend where we're starting to gain more inventory on the market. If there's enough buyer drive, then it's going to absorb that inventory. If there's not enough buyer drive, then we're going to start building inventory. So instead of 100 units for sale, we're going to have 200, 300. As long as that keeps going, then we're going to start getting into different real estate dynamics in the local market. We're going to transition from a seller's market into the in-between, which is kind of the middle between a seller and a buyer's market, and then finally into the buyer's market. Another great statistic to look at, though, happens to be that. Now, the next one we're going to look at, and I also talked about foreclosures, bank-owned properties, real estate-owned listings, and short sales, default sales as being part of that indicator, because if we start seeing a lot of those property types coming on the market, again, another great indicator that the market is starting to go from being somewhat healthy into a distressed mode. Now, taking longer to sell real estate, looking at those timelines, we're doing that as well, because the longer it takes to sell houses, it's going to indicate either a lot of inventory, lower buyer drive, but most likely it's a lower buyer drive. Another indication with regard to market health here in Santa Clarita Valley, and we look at these things. Now, when you're looking at real estate data, I will tell you that you want to look at a larger picture, a larger snapshot of what's going on, not week to week or maybe even month to month. You want a good chunk, 3, maybe 4 months. So maybe work it out in quarters per year, every 3 or so months, looking at that data. What happens is, and I put this in here in the fake real estate news cycle, because there's fake news everywhere, there are a lot of companies, a lot of people, syndication websites or whatever, that will put out information that might be true on some fronts, but ultimately are going to not be true in the overall case. They might put out things that have changed this week, but aren't going to be prevalent next week. So you can see that they'll take small tidbits of information, like a market change or a market shift, going from the winter months into the summer months, do those comparisons, and then throw out that data, getting people nervous or whatever the data is going to support. They're going to throw it out there being fake real estate news. Want to look at larger pieces. Anyway, I think it helps. Interest rates are also something incredibly important to look at. One of our local best lender here in Santa Clarita, he did help us prepare this. So he put together where those rates were as of yesterday, the 17th. But again, something to look at. And we're at 4 or less, just depending on your credit score and all those other factors. But when interest rates are high, or if interest rates go up or down, that's going to, again, cause the market to start to fluctuate. There's rumors that, you know, the powers that be want to get those interest rates down to 3%, which would really kick off that market moving, not only in resale fashion, but it would also kick off the market in refinance fashion. So in the resale and refinance world, it'd be incredible, because even yours truly, they went down to 3%, would be refinancing the real estate we own. But again, that's somewhat of a rumor. We'll see if that even happens. But right now, they're just about 4. And all time, not bad. Not bad at all. Really, really good interest rates. So it's something else. Price reductions in the Santa Clarita Valley. Now, currently, we're 38%. I redid the math on that. So we're 38% of the listings out there out of these 1,132, 432 had their prices decreased. So we see that. Whenever we see those numbers, it looks like the market's starting to change. This is month over month, so you're going to want to look at that data as well. What properties are having their prices changed? Of course, if it goes the other way, you see a lot of sellers starting to increase their prices online of the real estate they have for sale. Now, something's going on, especially if they're getting those higher prices, the market is starting to move even quicker. I'm Connor McIver. Please check out scvblog.com. It'll reroute you right here to SCV Nest. And I am absolutely honored that you took the time to watch this video. When you're ready, I'm here. Connor McIver, RE/MAX. Be safe, and we'll talk to you soon. Finding the off button is always wonderful.